Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So hello and good afternoon students. We've already seen the whole chapter, the theoretical part, the numerical, the mathematical part, the efficiencies, the work done, the forces. Now let's apply all those things in the numerical. So we'll be talking about different numericals here in this section. So now let's see the fourth question on centrifugal pumps. I'll read out the question. Find the power required to drive a centrifugal pump which delivers 0.05 meter cube of water per second to a height of 20 meter through a 15 centimeter diameter pipe of 100 meter length. Overall efficiency is 70% and the value of friction factor is 0.015. So first time in this question we've seen the value of friction factor is given, because here you need to calculate the value of head losses. Earlier questions were a little bit different. Here you need to calculate the head loss as well. So the friction factor is given to you. So let's write down the data first and then we'll see how we calculate power. So I've written all the given data. The diameter of the pipe through which the delivery is happening is given. The length of the pipe is given. The overall efficiency is given. The friction factor is given. So first of all, let's calculate the value of the velocity of the flow through the pipe. The value of velocity of flow through the pipe comes out to 2.26. Now we've got the velocity, and the reason behind finding velocity is because we need to calculate the head loss as well. So for head loss you need velocity, because head loss we've already seen in the chapter 3, losses in pipes, the head loss because of friction. So for that you need to know the value of velocity. So let's calculate the value of head loss because of friction. So if you can recollect the formula for Darcy's equation for head loss due to friction, it is 4FL V square upon 2GD. Now the value of F is known, the value of length of the pipe is known, the value of velocity we've calculated, the gravity value, the diameter value is known to you. Substitute everything in this equation and get the value of head loss. So we've got the HF, the value of head loss because of friction. Now the head that will be available will be nothing but the head minus the losses will be the available head. So total head is nothing but the impeller has to overcome this friction head as well as the head that is given to you. So impeller has to overcome both of them, the friction head and as well as the given head. So this is the total head that is obtained. Now we've got the value of total head. Now let's use the formula of overall efficiency and we can get the value of power that is developed. Overall efficiency is nothing but the power developed by the impeller or the pump divided by the shaft power. Now we'll get the shaft power very easily because overall efficiency is given. the value of rho GQH is known to you. Now substitute everything in this equation and get the value of shaft power. So the shaft power, once you multiply the numerator and divide with the denominator, you'll get the value of shaft power. So it comes out to 17046.97 watt. So you can write the power in terms of kilowatt as well. So you just need to divide the value by 1000, you'll get the value in kilowatts. So this is the shaft power that will be obtained from the pump. So it comes 17.046 kilowatt. So that was all about this question. We had to find the shaft power and we found it. So I hope you've understood this question. Thank you.